Members, could welcome all the new councillors to the chamber. I realise it's quite scary. I think I would just sit on my chair speaking. It does get a little bit intimidating. I will get to know what I'd like to do. Perhaps when the new councillors meet personally over the next few weeks and just have a chat with them before the next meeting. Some of you I already know, obviously. I'm looking at anybody in particular. So, nice to meet you. Welcome to the Deputy Mayor of Liverpool. The Assistant Mayor's current members and responsibilities of Mayoral Leads and Anderson.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. Can I advise Council the appointments of the following? Councillor Anne Corbett as Deputy Mayor. Councillors Wendy Simon, Nick Small and Gary Miller as Assistant Mayors. And the cabinet members are set out in Appendix 1. So, to save time, Lord Mayor, before you want to get upstairs, I'll just move that I've set out in the appendix to this note. And also, with the Mayor of Leeds, is sent out in Appendix 1. So, rather than do them. So, I'll just make this comment, though, Lord Mayor, on the particular issue. It was always my intention to use the position of Mayor of Leeds as an opportunity to give positions to opposition councillors, but other than Councillor Radford in the recent past, nobody else has made a contribution to support the council in any way. So it remained like the main administration in terms of Labour group of all those positions.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. And again, in the interest of brevity, can I move the printed notes?
Okay, is that agreed? Can we now move to agenda items 9 and 10 and all supporting reports relating to these items together? Is that agreed? Sorry, Alan.
Again, Lord Mayor, can we move the notes printed?
Sorry,
I think it is worth commenting that when I was younger, the Labour Party had a tradition in many, many boroughs of almost excluding opposition parties from it. And for those of us who believed in Blairism, it was disappointing. And I think, in contrast, it is worth commenting. For those people who are concerned about Blairism and debate, whilst they disagree with the voting system, I think it's to the credit of the Council that opposition parties are an additional proportionality representation on committees more than they're entitled to. And I think that's a positive move. And I think it would be quite wrong not to pass comment on that. And it's a change that I think is refreshing. And I'd like to thank the Mayor for doing so. There's no legal requirement. If anything, it's the reverse. It's giving an additional representation. And I think from those of us who believe we should be a constructive opposition, I think it's only right we draw attention to that.
Thank you, Councillor. Any comments
now? Well, obviously, we've got those comments from Councillor Ruff. We made the same reports from last year that we have this year. I think it's in the interest of opening frank conversations with select committees that the opposition have an opportunity to speak and raise issues. We did it last year, we've done it again this year, and hopefully the opposition parties will fully participate in the debates and the conversations with those committees.
Can we now take agenda items 9 and 10 and also call three? Oh, sorry. Three, thank you. Will you bear with me while I confuse this for different agencies down there? Can we now take agenda items 9 and 10 and also call three reports relating to these items? We've done that
three times.
You know what? Can I just go from the gear? I've eaten nothing.
Past, but we need to be mindful that this can and will not continue forever. At some stage, it council will accept the recommendation from our, but again, for the 19th, we're not doing that. And can I just point out, for the officers on page 181 of the report that I understand is prepared by Holton Borough Council, they say that the chief fire officer is appointed by this board of years, and they point it out. So if we can correct that and advise Holton to make a mistake.
Is that, have we got an amendment from Mr. Romeo on this item?
Thank you. Yeah, it's a very straightforward amendment. We are proposing to reduce the mayor allowance from £79,500 to £57,250. That represents a saving to the council of £22,250 per year, which over a four-year mayoral term would represent a saving to the council of £89,000. This is roughly equal in quantity to the amount used to pay the mayor's legal bill.
I'm sorry, Councillor.
This is just the rationale.
The legal advice. The point is that this amendment relates to the role of the mayor, not Mayor Anderson specifically. And I think that's the legal advice to the board. So you cannot move into that. You're moving an amendment on that allowance.
So that's the amendment to reduce
not
it.
Not on the rationale that you believe is behind it.
Okay, well, that's the amendment.
Lord Mayor, obviously we oppose that. We've had this issue raised consistently by the opposition over the last God knows how long. We've had full and frank explanations from the chief officers responsible for this decision. It's not something that we take lightly, but there's obviously no way that we support this amendment. It's, in our opinion, it's a nonsensical amendment. It's something that some political parties base most of their campaign on the elections, and we saw what happened. The minister sitting here. So, obviously, we're opposing it.
Yeah, I'm going to move to the vote now. Yeah, sorry, I'm moving to the vote. I'm moving to the vote. All right, sorry. Councillor Kenman.
I should just be brief to explain why we're not supporting this amendment. All the allowances in this document have been agreed by an independent panel who've judged their worth. We believe that you often get democracy on the cheap, and that it should be open to every councillor, or in this case the mayor, slightly different, to take that which they're entitled to with that independent review. Whether individual councillors or individual mayors take all of that is up to their personal circumstances. If I was a millionaire, I probably wouldn't take anything, but I'm not, so I take something. So we have to leave it to the discretion of the individual to take what they think is right, up to the allowance which is allowed by the independent panel. So on that basis, we will not support the amendment.
Okay, thank you,
Councillor
Kenman. Okay, can we move to take vote then, please? In favour of the amendment?
I understand Richard Kemp's point of view, the put to council we should support the scheme, but over the years I've always thought for the amount of additional work chairman committees have to do and having done that the amount of payment is far higher than it needs to be. But I also think that the work of ward councillors is undervalued. So I will not be voting on the scheme of allowances, and I just want to explain why. I don't think that is disparity to anybody or any particular role. It's a view I've held strongly for some time. It's points of view I've shared to the panel. So I don't feel I can have that view and honestly support the scheme. I don't see that we should get to any part of the way. I don't think the package is rightly balanced, and I wanted to express that view before I spend the money.
Okay, thank you,
Councillor.
And
Madam,
I just comment on that. I mean, we specifically asked the panelists here to look at some of the positions that Councillor Dobbins mentioned to make sure they passed the test in terms of the allowances that they received. And they've come back and said, yeah, basically, if it is correct, it does fit the bill. So I understand what he's saying. We had some concerns, but it's been tested, and they've come back and said, no, what today is about, right? So we're happy with that.
Now, will you move to this in the motion to those against the motion. Sorry, what is in favour of the meeting. Thank you for your